here's where I camped last night. Nice spot. And here's my neighbors. Turns out a minivan joined us that I didn't know about. Logging Road Camp Squad, fam. Quick little morning pit stop in Squamish. Had to get water, Gatorade, and a BC map book for some back road action. The clerk in there who was working was like so nice. She was like the friendliest little lady ever. She was just in the best mood. Respect. I never realized how nice the Sea to Sky Highway was until now. This place is freaking beautiful. That's where we are. Shannon, looking good today. Wonder if I go up that way, if I can get closer. All right, so first waterfall of the trip. Not too bad, not too bad. The other one's got a little bit to live up to. Feeling pretty well rested. I went to bed at like 9 o'clock last night. Got up today around 7. That's a decent 9 hours of sleep. Pretty sure that's what that equals. I still gotta go buy groceries and earphones for my computer. We'll see what happens.
So shout out to all the other car campers that have been by my side on this trip so far. Respect. Car camper. Hey, I'm sorry, but Walmart in Squamish has to have like the best mountain backdrop of all Walmarts in the world.
Just walked out of Walmart. Everyone is so nice today. I don't know if it's because it's like early in the morning. It's a good day. So I've been thinking about this a little bit, and this whole vlogging thing is a little more difficult than I anticipated. Really got to get used to like people looking at you funny when you're talking, bringing your camera around, filming everything, switching between camera settings and movie settings. Anyways, apples for breakfast.
She'll always get the best of me. The worst is yet to come. All the misery was necessary when we're...
So the sign talks about the Ring of Fire and how most of the earthquakes and volcanic eruptions occur on the edges of the Pacific Plate. And looking at this diagram, the Pacific Ocean is literally a ring of fire. What? Alexander, looking sharp today, man. There's some nice water. All right, so we found gravel, dirt roads. It's gonna be a long, bumpy, potholy drive. So, I know this dip doesn't look too bad, and I don't think it's too bad. But we're gonna see how the Subi gets through it. I'm so sorry, Subaru.
This back road is so nice. You got these beautiful mountain views.
To the left of me, there's some really nice mountains, but these trees are in the way. Always trees getting in the way.
We made it to Cather's Lake, and so did this Honda Accord.
Check this out. This has definitely been one of the nicer lakes that I've seen ever. And I found my bathing suit. Oh my God, thank you. All right, so turns out that logging road took a bit of a toll on the old Scoobs. Just kidding, only this little plastic piece came off, so gonna have to rip it off or something. Sick. All right, it's a good thing. I didn't actually have to rip it off like I thought. I just threw a little zip tie on there. It was good as new. Currently hiking along the Rainbow Trail and this nice little view of the mountains up here. It's pretty sweet. Whistler is actually such a nice place. There's all these trails, mountain biking roads, mountain biking trails, waterfalls, lakes, campgrounds, RV parks, and it's all like free use stuff for the public. It's incredible out here. I'm currently hiking along Rainbow Trail and it's so nice. Whistler is awesome. I never knew how awesome Whistler is until now. This place is great. I think this is Rainbow Falls. I don't know if this is actually it. We're gonna go try and find it, but this one's pretty cool either way. You got a big one and you got a small one. You got a big one and you got a small one. You got a big one and you got a small one. Big, small, big, small. I need some sort of mount, because right now I'm just doing like handheld vlog shots. Don't die, because I don't know how shaky this footage is right now. I mean, I'm lucky that I have the in-body stabilization with the Sony, but I feel like it could still be a bit better. I haven't even seen any real vlog footage yet. I still have yet to edit, so I think this will be my second or third vlog by the time I get it out. Yeah, learning as we go. So, I'm like a total tourist right now. I don't even care. This place is awesome. And it's like, just when you think, you know, things can't get any cooler, or like this place can't get any more awesome, they have this huge green blue lake just chilling here with like this beautiful mountain backdrop. What?
Like, look at those mountains and this green lake. You can't beat this. It's pretty crazy.
Seen a turn off for a place called Nairn Falls. I think that's how you say it. I don't normally take turn offs, but let's do it, see what it holds. Whoa. Nairn. Nairn. Look at this watercolor. It's crazy. So here I am at Nairn Falls, about to make my tuna sandwich, and
these two guys just came out of the bush holding kayaks, and they're getting into their convertible BMW,
which the license plate says kayaks on it. Legends, love it. Emerton Meadows Road has to be one of the nicest roads I've ever driven on. Here we are outside of Pemberton, and if you look behind me, there's a huge forest fire throwing up these like huge plumes of smoke. It's pretty crazy. Yeah, you can see it from miles away. I wasn't sure what it was, but once you get closer, you can see like the helicopters coming in and dropping water. It's pretty crazy. So, forest fire behind me. Just met these dudes shooting a longboarding video for Arbor Skateboards down in Venice. That's actually pretty sweet because I ride an Arbor board. You can see the helicopter coming in, dropping water. This is crazy. Just got to Joffrey Lakes. I've never been here before, so I'm actually really looking forward to this. I wasn't initially planning on coming here. I don't know why. I have no excuse. I don't know. I just didn't even think about stopping here, but I seen the sign and I was like, you know what? This place looks like it's really sweet. There's this beautiful glacier.
and mountain range right behind, so. And it's like, probably hard to tell, but it's almost sunset, so it's like golden hour. It's beautiful. So I just made it to Joffrey Lakes, the lower one, and I wish I had a drone to show how blue this water is. It's pretty freaking nuts. Of course the camera has a hard time picking it up. I need to be a bit higher, I think, but got that glacier in the background. It's crazy out here. I'm really loving this place. I honestly think that driving at golden hour is the best possible time you can drive, especially when you're in BC. Honestly though, this road is so nice. I've got perfect weather this trip. So far, this is only my first day, and it's just been blue skies and sunshine all day. I'm really thankful for it. I'm feeling super grateful right now. I've met some really great people already. It's only been like a day, 24 hours into this adventure, and I've already met some really great people, which is kind of sweet. So who knows? We'll see what else is coming. Just got to the Cottonwood Recreation Site, somewhere between Pemberton and Kamloops. There's a couple other people here, but overall the whole campground is pretty much empty. Obviously it's a free use campground. It's all user maintained. It's cool as fuck. I'm gonna camp out here for the night. It's only about 6:45 right now, but I decided to stop driving for the rest of the day and chill on this beautiful. My campground is like literally 20 steps from the river, so that's pretty sweet. But yeah, I'm gonna take a break. Eat some dinner. I'm hungry. I haven't like had some good food in a little while, so I'm gonna eat. All right, got the Subi all ready for bed. Well, I gotta get some work done first, but she's cozy. Oh, can't forget. Oh, the twinkly lights. They don't twinkle actually, but the camping lights, they're pimp. If there's something that I've learned so far from this trip that I kind of want to put into a video, it's be super nice to people and be outgoing. Honestly, just stop and like talk to people, say hey, what's up, if you're on the trails or literally anywhere, like on the ferry, just anything, you know. Talk to people, see what they're up to, see who they are, find out, you know, and you can meet a lot of cool people that way. But anyways, that's all I got, so catch you on the next one.